to say good morning to the Sunday school class today, and we have another fine lesson. Amen. Lesson 10, August 9th, 2020. Unit 3, Faith and Wisdom in James. And the subject is a very good subject. Talk is cheap. Amen. I'd like to say giving honor to God and to our pastor and wife and all of our ministers and deacons, trustees, and our church family, and also to our superintendent, Brother Nehemiah. We thank God for him and his family, and we ask everyone to continue praying for Crystal and Tim and the passing of their cousin. Amen. We ask you to pray for them that they remain strong and be encouraged. Amen. There's a lot going on in the world today, and we have a lot we have to deal with right now, but we know the Lord is still in control. Amen. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we come to you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for all the many blessings you have bestowed upon us, Lord. Bless and strengthen us that we grow stronger, Lord. Bless us that the word become a part of our lives, that we be able to live the word, that we study and read about the everything that you have told us to do. We ask you, Lord, that bless us that we be able to put those things into action in our lives, Lord. We love you. We praise you, Lord, for everything you've done and everything you've done throughout our lives, Lord. We give you honor and praise. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Very good lesson. Talk is cheap. Amen. And it is cheap. Amen. You find out a lot of times we love to sit around and talk, and you look at the talk shows are very popular, and people love to sit around and talk. Amen. You look at the talk shows, some of the shows that they have on, that they can solve a problem in 1 hour. I mean, it's just 1 hour and then the problem is solved. But we find out there's a lot of things going on in our lives that 1 hour won't solve. Amen. We have to put our trust in the Lord. He can change things for us quickly, but a lot of things, you know, we go through. Amen. It may take a little time for us to get through those things. Amen. And people will tell you one thing and do another. Amen. We can make our mouths say anything. Amen. The Lord say, we come close to him with our lips, but our hearts are far from him. So, you can say anything. Amen. And the power of life and death is in the tongue. And the lesson gave a good example of that. How a person, you know, you with road rage, and how our mouth can cause us to lose our lives. Amen. Just because we can't keep our mouths closed. Amen. We just gotta get back. We gotta say something. Amen. We'll say, I'm not gonna let the person disrespect me like that. But it's really about being humble and with humility. Amen. When Jesus was on the cross, amen, they say, if you be the Son of God, come down from the cross and save us and save yourself. Amen. They were challenging him even on the cross. Amen. And you can't listen to everything people say. People will try to make you prove yourself all the time. And they'll tell you one thing and they'll do another. Amen. A lot of times, even in the church, amen, people will say they're going to be there and they don't. Amen. We have a meeting a lot of times, you know, they'll rejoice and say, yeah, let's do this and let's do that. But when it comes time to doing the actual work, amen, you won't find them. Amen. And that's through experience. Amen. This is something that I'm not just talking about, but have seen over the years. Amen. So talk is cheap. Amen. Talk is very, 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 very cheap. Amen. As we go into our lesson, the 19th verse says, wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear. Amen. Slow to speak, slow to wrath. So we should listen first, amen, and not judge a situation before time, amen. Sometimes we'll fly off the handle and it really, something is really not that bad, or it's not that bad of a situation, but we'll get angry, we'll fly off the handle swift. We'll be more swift to get angry, amen. Instead of listening to the situation, we'll just fly off the handle, amen. But the Lord tells us to be swift to hear, because our life can depend on what we hear coming in our ears, amen. We're gonna be judged by every idle word that come out of our mouth, and even the person that is causing, may be causing us a problem or causing us to be angry or at them, amen. The Lord say we're to go to that person in secret and try to gain them and tell them, you know, let them know, you know, their fault. Let them know what it is that they're causing you to feel any way toward them. Amen. So we're to go to them, and then if they don't hear you, then you take another person. Then the next time you bring them to the church. Amen. So there are ways to solve problems, but a lot of times we don't want to take. We don't have patience enough to solve it. Amen. We're not patient enough to wait till the problem is worked out. Amen. Let me tell you this: you don't always win. Amen. I've said this a few weeks ago. Amen. We don't always win. We think we're the best fighter. We think we're, you know, we quicker on the draw, and we find out a lot of times we can end up on the bad side of a situation. Amen. So it's very important that our life may depend on what we do and how we react to a situation. Amen. So be slow to speak. Don't just start cussing somebody out, or, you know, just start cussing. We love to cuss. We love to use profanity. Amen. And that shows the words that we use in for profanity. We use it certain words that we know that it's going to offend the other person when we say them. Amen. So we should be slow to speak, slow to wrath, slow to be angry, slow to get back, so slow to show vengeance. Try to avenge ourselves. Amen. The Lord said, "Vengeance is mine; I will repay." If we let the Lord deal with these situations, things will be much better. Amen. But we put ourselves in the place of God, and remember this: we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So if some things we get angry about, we've done in the past to other people. Amen. Some people say, "Well, why are they talking about me? Why are they saying these things about me? You know, I'm gonna get them back. I can't stand them, or, you know." But listen, have you ever talked about anybody? Have you ever said things that could hurt other people's feelings? Amen. Not just out in public, but behind closed doors. You reap what you sow. Amen. And a lot of times, we're just reaping what we sow, and we should take it patiently. You should take it, because you have said things and you've done things in your life that have caused people to hurt people's feelings. Amen. And when I say this, let me say this too. A lot of times, even how we talk to our kids. Amen. We call our kids dumb. We call our kids stupid. We call them ignorant. Amen. And when you start feeding that type of stuff into your child, what do you think your child is going to think? They're going to think, "I'm dumb, I'm stupid, I'm ignorant." Amen. We have to lift them up. Even though we have to discipline them, you still have to do it in a way where it don't bring them down. Say, "Father, do not provoke your children to anger." Amen. There's a reason. If there is a reason for correction, you have to do it in a certain way. Amen. So we have to use the wisdom and the knowledge that God has given us so we can help, even help our children. Amen. So 20 verse says, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. So you're not doing anything for the kingdom of heaven by fighting. God told Peter, he said, Peter, put your sword up. He said, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. What's happening right now? People are living by the gun and they're dying by the gun. Amen? Children are dying by the gun. See, what you, that gun, you're thinking, I'm going to be the fastest shot. I'm going to be able to shoot them before they shoot me. But listen, you may not get off the shot. They might shoot you first. Amen? So the Lord told Peter, put your sword up. Amen. The Lord didn't need Peter to fight for him. The Lord could have just told those people, lay down and die, and they would all die. Amen. But that wasn't the purpose of Jesus being on this earth, is to come here and just kill us all. Because it's so easy. We see by this disease that's going around right now, it's so easy to kill us off. We can't even see it. We can't even stop what we're doing long enough to find out a cure. We can't even wait on that. So, amen. Those that are proud and boastful, they said, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to wear a mask. I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to do that. But you put in your mouth, the power of life and death is in your tongue. Amen. What you say, you lift it up in pride, and what you say you're not going to do can cause you to lose your life. Amen. Amen. So wrath does not work the righteousness of God. So don't say, I did it because I'm doing it for the Lord. The Lord ain't told, Jesus ain't told you to fight anybody. He said, fight the devil. That's who he tell you to fight. Fight the devil. Use that energy to fight off the devil and the wiles of the devil that's coming after you. Amen. So, wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness. Everything that come out of my filth. We look at the music that the young folks listen to. Even we did it back in the day. We listened to all kind of filth records. The comedy records, they had nothing but filth in it. Moms Mabley, Richard Pryor, Red Fox, all these people had some of the most filthiest words and the cussing and all kind of profanity in it, and we sat there and listened to it. Now they're doing the same thing, it's just more of it. Amen. They got this music, and the music got all kind of filth, calling the women all kind of just terrible names, and the people are dancing to it, and this stuff is feeding into us. Amen. Into their minds. Amen. So if you keep feeding that stuff in you, that's what you're gonna be. You're gonna be just like, so man, you're gonna be just like what you letting, allowing to come inside of you. Amen. So that stuff will become a part of you. Amen. So don't even listen to it. Amen. Find good stuff. Find some Christian music, music that's gonna encourage your heart. Amen. Amen. So we're supposed to lay aside all that filthiness and anything naughty things, and receive with meekness the engrafted word. Now that's what we need. We need to be feeding ourselves with the word, which is able to what? Save your soul. That's what we need. The things that's gonna save our souls. If you're not saved, amen. If you live to be 100 and you're not saved, that's as long as you're going to live. That's it. Amen. So we want to live forever, eternal. Amen. Forever. Amen. Now, 22nd verse says, but be ye doers of the word and not hearers only. Now, when we go to church, when we go to church, amen, is we're not just to go there and say, well, that boy, the preacher really preached today, or we heard in the teaching in the Sunday school, oh, the Sunday school teacher really taught today. But then when you get home, you go and do just the opposite of what was taught. See, it's not just coming there and showing up, but it's coming there and getting the food. And then once you get the food, it's ingesting the food into your spirit, allowing those things to become a part of you. And guess what? You hear the word and you do the word. Amen. And listen, and the word says you're deceiving your own self. Amen. You're tricking your own self. You think you do. You say, well, I did go to church this week. But if you don't live it all week long, amen, every day, amen, it doesn't make any difference. Amen. You just went to church for a couple hours, then you went home. Amen. For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. And that's when you look in the mirror, amen, for he beholds himself and goes his way and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. And you see yourself in the mirror, and then you look at yourself and you say, oh yeah, okay. And then you walk away, and then you say, wait a minute, did I comb my hair? Did I do this? I did that this morning. Amen. I went to the mirror, and then I put a shirt on, and I said, wait a minute. Did I comb my hair? Amen. You would have saw me on this video with my hair sticking up. Amen. Because I forgot what I look like. Amen. But the Lord reminded me, which is that what the word does. It reminds you. It lets you know what you look like, who you really are. Now, if we can remember those things and keep those things in mind, then those things, then we can apply them to our lives. Amen. So we look in the mirror, and this is our mirror. The Word of God, the Bible, is our mirror. It tells everything about us. When you look in that mirror, you see every spot, every blemish, everything that is not correct, that need correcting. And when you sit there, and many women, they put their makeup on and they put cover stuff on, they cover up everything. Amen. But God see beyond that. Amen. God see the inner man. Amen. And that's what the lesson is talking about today. The inner man. Amen. So we can't cover up our sins. We have to expose. God exposes those things so we can pray for them. The Word of God exposes those things. And when we look into the Word, it shows all the spots. It shows all the blemishes. It shows everything that we need to do to change and be like Christ. Amen. The 25th verse says, but whosoever looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, he being not a forgetful hearer. Now you got to continue. You can't just say, I'm gonna live for Christ today, and then I'm just gonna not live for Christ tomorrow, then the next day I'm gonna do it, and then the next day I'm gonna be a Christian, and the next day I'm gonna be a sinner. God wants us to continue therein and being not a forgetful hearer. This lesson today. How many really study the word? How many really study their lesson? How many just pick it up one day and on Sunday before we get to Sunday school, you read it and then you say, yeah, we got a good lesson today. But you really haven't even studied your lesson. You just do it for that one day. Amen. You read it for that day, and you get to class, and boy, you start talking about the lesson, then guess what? It's gone. Amen. After that day is over, you don't remember anything because you never studied. You never went in depth to find out what this lesson was really talking about. And all of this applies to everybody, not just one person, but everybody. This man, it said, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. That means whatever we do for the Lord, we will be blessed if we follow what he tell us to do. Amen. If we be not forgetful in what God has told us, we have to take these things that God is showing us in his word. We have to take these things and apply them to our lives. It's not just hearing it and then just letting it, you know, go in one ear and out the other. We have to remember. We have to study. We have to remember. Say, listen, this is what God said in this situation. Someone is treating me bad. What did Jesus do? How would he have dealt with that problem? And it lets you know in the word how to deal with those things. Be quick to hear and slow to speak and slow to wrath. Amen. The Lord tells us, be angry and sin not. Amen. So we can control even our anger. Something will make us angry. Our kids will make us angry. Amen. But we have to know how to even control our anger with our kids. Amen. So we got to apply these things that God have given us. Amen. Praise God. We have to apply these things God have given us in his word to our lives. Amen. Praise God. Let's go to 26. If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is in vain. If you can't control your tongue, the things that come out of your mouth, you're in trouble. Because guess what? Every idle word that we speak, we're going to have to give account of. In judgment. God is going to judge us. And by your word, you're going to be condemned or you're going to be saved by what come out of your mouth. Amen? So this is very important. We have to choose our words carefully. When we start talking about one another, when we backstabbing one another, when you calling people ugly, when you talk about people's clothes, when you talk about people, what they wearing, how they look, what kind of hairstyle they got, when you start talking about these people, guess what? You put yourself in danger. Amen. And then when somebody say the same thing about you, you ready to get mad. You're angry. You're ready to get angry because they said this. They said, should have said that about me. But look at the things you've said over the years. Amen. We have to be conscious of the things that we say and allow to come out of our mouth, because you reap what you sow. If you sow bad stuff out of your mouth, guess what? Bad stuff going to come back to you. Amen. Pure religion, 27 said, pure religion, amen, but deceive his own heart. This is 26. If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, but deceives his own heart, that this man religion is in vain. You going to church for nothing. Because guess what? If you don't control your flesh, if you don't control your mouth, you're gonna end up in hell. You if you can go for 100 years to church, and if you don't have control over your flesh and what come out of you, guess what? Your religion is in vain. That's what the word is saying. It's in vain. So we have to put a muzzle on our mouths. Amen. You can take an elephant and you can tame it. You can take an elephant, you can tell that elephant, take a whip and hit it, and that elephant will stand up on his two hind legs. Amen. You know an elephant don't walk on his hind legs, but just because you tame it and you tell it what to do, it'll stand up. You can take a ship that has this little bitty wheel and this big old giant ship, and you can turn it right or left or whatever way to go you want to go. Amen. And it'll go in that direction. But the tongue is hard to tame. My father preached a sermon a long time ago. He said the tongue is like a gun. Amen. It can fire off things, and once it fire out of your mouth, guess what? It's hard to bring it back. Amen. Let me say this too. If you a lot of people say, well, that they'll say something and hurt, offend someone with something that come out of their mouth, and then they'll say, I didn't mean to say that. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say it. Yes, you did mean to say it. Because guess what? That is what was in your heart. You allow what was in your heart to come out of your mouth. Amen? So you did mean it. The Lord say, we are carried away of our own lust. Amen? So that thing that you spoke was right in your heart. So don't say, well, I didn't mean to say it. Just say you sorry. Don't even say, put I didn't mean to say it on there. I didn't mean to do that. If you punch me in my face today, if you came to me and just punched me in my face, guess what? You meant to punch me in my face. Amen. Praise God. If you hit me or whatever you do to me, you mean to do it. Don't say I didn't mean it, because you're lying. Then the truth is not in you. Amen. So therefore, those things that we do come out of us. It's come right from my heart. Amen. If you cuss me out, you meant to cuss me out. Don't say I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to cuss you. Yes, you did mean it, because it came out of you. Amen. So this is what God wants us to do. It's 27 verse 6. Take that energy and do this. This is what the energy God wants you to take. Be quiet, and this is what God wants you to do. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this. To visit the Father, do that instead of visiting and gossiping and saying stuff about people on Facebook and on whatever these social media things. Stop talking about people. Go and visit somebody instead of talking about people. Take that energy and put it in something good, and then instead of just putting it into, you know, degrading people and laughing at people. We go on YouTube, we laughing at people, we just amen. But then as soon as somebody laughs at us, we ready to fight. Amen. Visit the fathers, widows in their affliction. Not just visiting people when they're doing good. The Lord wants you to visit them when they're not at their best. Amen. That's when they really need you. Amen. So in their affliction, when they're going through in different situations, we're to visit them. You can get in many what ways can you visit? You can call them. We can call. Amen. Praise God. God made it very easy for us today. You can visit someone by calling them, and you can talk to them on the phone. You can use those the same lips, the same mouth. Amen. You can use it to inspire people, to make people feel good within themselves, and to give them a good word. Amen. My father also said this word in his sermon. He said that God put the tongue in prison. And it wasn't the prison, wasn't the bars or the teeth. He locked it up. He locked that tongue behind the teeth. Amen. So we'll be able to control it. Amen. And we're still struggling. That's the most hardest thing to do, is to stop talking. Amen. And listen. And to keep himself unspotted from the world. You have enough to do to keep yourself right with God. Amen. You don't need to be in other people trying to, you know, work out everything. You can pray for them, but work out everything for everybody else. We need to work on ourselves. We might have problems ourselves. Amen. Let me read this, and then we're going to close on this. The seventh chapter of St. Mark. Amen. And the 14th verse, I'm with you, 14 through the 23rd verse. Amen. It says, and when he had called all the people unto him, he said unto them, hearken unto me, every one of you, and understand. There is nothing from without a man that entereth into him can defile him. But the things which come out of him, those are they that defile the man. If any man have ears to hear, let him hear. Now, you can hear a lot of stuff. You know, you've been on jobs where you hear nothing but filth. Amen. But that don't defile you. It's only until you allow those same things that you hear to come out of you. Amen. You hear what I'm saying? When it come out of you, it's not what they say. That's on them. but it's what come out of you. And the 17th verse says, and when he was entered into the house from the people, his disciples asked him concerning the parable. And he said unto them, are ye so without understanding also? Do ye not perceive that whatsoever thing from without enters into the man, it cannot defile him? So food, all kind of stuff, you know, whatever we eat, those things do not defile us, amen, because it enters, the 19 says, because it enters not into his heart, but into what? The belly, and goeth out into the drought, purging all meat. So all, whatever we eat, go in and come out. And they, at this time, the disciples was concerned about washing their hands and cleaning their hands. You know, we doing through this thing with coronavirus, we have to wash our hands and clean everything, but that does not wipe away sin. You can't wash, you can slap someone and then you say, well, let me wash my hands and I'll be clean. Guess what? That does not clean you. Until you ask for forgiveness of that person and of God, then, amen, you still not clean. Amen. 20th verse says, he said, that which cometh out of the man, that defileth the man. For from within, out of the heart of men, proceed what? Evil thoughts, even thinking about what you're going to do to somebody. I could kill him. Oh, I hate him. Amen. That's coming out of you. And that's what you're thinking. That's what that caused us to be defiled. Amen. For from within, evil thoughts, adulteries, fornication. Remember I told you last week, my problem I had with fornication. That came from my heart. That came from within. I cannot blame anybody for that. Amen. Because I sin and come short of the glory of God. Amen. We'd like to thank everyone for their listening ear. It's been a blessing. Amen. We'd like to thank Brother Tim and Sister Crystal. Continue praying for them. Amen. And amen. They did a wonderful job. And Paula also. Amen. She's doing a great job. Let's pray for them. Amen. God have allowed them to help us in getting these things set up so we still can hear the word. But we actually continue praying for our pastor and just pray for our whole entire congregation that we continue to grow stronger. Amen. And we thank God and we give God the glory and the praise in the name of Jesus.